All right, welcome. This is the TI5 Grand Finals between EG versus CDEC. This is my first time casting Dota 2. And what better time to do it in the biggest stage of the year? My pick for today will probably be Evil Geniuses. They will win 3-1. Although I am hoping for a 5-game series as long as they are close. TI5 has been living up to the expectation that I expected. Much better than TI4. The team fights have been excellent and most of the games have not been boring at all. Anyways, let's get straight to the game here. We got Lashrek and PL for CDEC, while Dire will have Gyro Clockwork for Evil Geniuses. Probably looking at Fear on the Gyro and your offlane Universe on the Clockwork. Banning the Tusk Bounty Hunter and Darkseer here. Now you see the Techies also being banned for CDEC. You do not want AUI on that hero. He is making a name for that hero in this tournament. Trying to see, PL has been a very strong carry this game. Lashrek, rarely picked actually because of the high ban rate, I believe. I haven't been really keeping up with TI5 thoroughly. I've just been catching up on every game here and there. So I don't know what's that been about, but last I heard, Illidan was on the Lashrek in the safe lane, and that didn't go so well. So I'm sure CDEC here will make a greater impact on that hero on the mid lane. Now, using a lot of time here, thinking about their third pick, EG. Probably looking for a support here. They will tap in their reserve time. So we'll see. I don't know. What do EG really play here? Or they already got a hero for Fear, Universe probably. I'm looking for an AUI support, possibly. Perhaps something to contain the PL. Someone that can rotate because CDEC are known to gank very early and snowball out of control here. Still using a lot of time and CM for AUI 2K. I'm not sure if this is a pick here. Very squishy against those lineup. But they do have the Clockwork. So perhaps everything will be okay. It is Evil Geniuses after all. Although they have fallen to CDEC the last time they met. And it wasn't really much of a contest, actually. I believe the second game, first game was very close. Although the second game, they tapped out very early, understanding that there was no way for them to come back from that game. And now, CDEC, I am very looking forward to see what they have in store. Winter Wyvern, one of the newer heroes added to the Dota 2 pool. And the Storm Spirit for Sumail. We've seen Storm very capable of snowballing out of control if you do not have the right items or the right hero to contain him. And they do have a Winter Wyvern with its ultimate here, the Winter's Curse, allowing him to be disabled and perhaps even attacked by his teammate for the prolonged duration. Very underrated ultimate, in my opinion. Stun, and not only that, but a mini black hole, if you will, if their teammates are within the distance. Now the fourth pick for CDEC Gaming. Do they have an off lane yet? No, perhaps that may be the next pick, or if not, probably a support here. Someone, perhaps another stun? I would really like a Skywrath pick here, but I'm just being biased because I do love playing the Skywrath as a support. Especially against squishy heroes. And Spirit Breaker off lane is actually not bad. Very good for CDEC. One of a fighting hero capable of running across the entire map. And they will ban Undying here. I think that's a very, very good ban pick coming from evil geniuses. They understand that if they let that go through and all they do is fight, they have the Leshrac to push. It's looking really, really slim. Or I should say it would look really bad for EG had they had to face an Undying. Now we got a minute left until the final pick for EG in this game one of the TI5 Grand Finals. Most likely gonna be picking another support for PPD. And at this point, what do you pick really? You got the clockwork. Oh, sorry, that was a bit ban time. The fifth ban for CEC. That was my bad. Yeah, you can see the rookie mistakes that I'm making. No biggie. Whatever. All right, now is the fifth pick for EG. Come on, Mastermind, PPD, show us what you have. Take it home for the North Americans. All right, tapping in. There's a reserve time. Still got a good minute. Have to admit, drafting solo casting is kind of weird for me, to be honest. Oh, Skywrath. Interesting. Is that the right pick here? I mean, yeah, it's not bad. It really synchronizes well with Clockwork, and the silence would be very useful against the PL, especially if he doesn't have Manta. Not a bad pick, not a bad pick. Although their heroes are a little bit squishy. But should be fine. Evil geniuses after all. Now the counter for CDEC. Sorry. I don't know if I mentioned, but I am a little under the weather. But when it's TI5, you just gotta suck it up and go for it. Right, 20 seconds to go. What will be the last pick for these underdogs? CDEC Gaming, where no one, and I'm pretty sure no one, really saw coming. Being here in the final stages of the game, and the Quap will come out. What is this? Is this the Quap off lane? Spirit Breaker support. All right, we got aggressive on the PLQ on the Winter Wyvern, Shiki on the Queen of Pain, Sumail obviously on the Storm Spirit, Fear, Gyrocopter, and looking for the remaining four players to select their heroes, and we will be on our way to game one of the TI5 Grand Finals. May the best man win. All right, for game one, I believe I will. Here we go. I'll let them control the camera for me. Just gotta get a good look of how they look about things. All right, there we go. Just waiting on you now. AUI will be on the Skywrath, not the Crystal Maiden. PPD on the CM, and look, a quick teleport here from Universe to get great position on the camps or vision here. All right. I'm probably gonna. How do I mute this chat actually? All right, there you go. All right, good luck. Have fun coming out of PPD. Aggressive as well. Returning favor with good luck. And we are on our way. Four heroes on top. Spirit Breaker. Very close. I wish the camera would pan up to him, click on him. All right, let's see what he has. He has a mango and very healthy regens here. Got us over at a sentry. You know what? It's not working out. I believe I'm just gonna. All right, I'm gonna take this over, actually. All right, what do we have here? We got fear with an observer ward. Sumail, two tangos. No, look at this. No items on the clockwork as of yet. Is he gonna buy anything on the courier? What is he a rush a bottle? Let's see if these guys ping out anything. Got a sentry on this. And no, that's a sentry from EG here. And I have no idea what the pause is about. Let's get this game on the way. Okay. We're gonna have to take a look at our lanes. Clockwork will probably go against the PL Winter Wyvern support blocking the camp. Garter. Huh. Actually, I have no idea who's the mid player for CDEC actually. I'm gonna check that now. Was it Shiki? It should be Shiki. So we're looking at a support Lesh here. Is that right? All right. Or perhaps even offlane Lesh, and we'll have a roaming Spirit Breaker. This is a very interesting lineup. I love the way they are thinking outside the box, so we will, if you will. All right, AUI. EG and company, I'm gonna have an extra observer ward and aggressive. Being aggressive. Let's get a couple hits by the tower. Right, by cutting the tree, what was his, was he just simply scouting? He does buy some items on the courier. And we are on our way. The horns will be sounding in 5 seconds. Creep will spawn, and bounty gold will go. One and one in favor of each team. Queen of Pain, Sword of Spirit, both mid heroes will start off with 100 gold and 100 XP. Right. Here we go. PPD, perhaps backing them up. All right, now look at this matchup here. He did skill Q first, the poison shadow strike, level 2 Sumail with the overcharge here, overload. Sorry. All right, this camera work is like terrible right now. Gonna have to work on that. Let's go back to all right. This camera. How do they? The way they move the camera. I gotta work on that. Oh, another pause. All right, boys, tactical pause here. Got a little malfunction, and they're good to go. On the off lane, obviously going to be hard for Universe Clockwork to get any decent farm, especially with PL spamming at you and Winter Wyvern behind you. In mid lane, Sumail is actually pulling ahead of Shiki. Not afraid of the Shadow Strike. He's actually put in two. An early salve being popped here on the quap. Sumail just going to town here. 8-2 in favor of mid. Shiki only 2-2. And he's already bottle crowing, I believe. Two Minute Ruin is coming out though. But I think he anticipated that he might not be able to get it. He does want control of the lane, so he'll go for the early bottle Crone. Very great vision here, allowing to see the Lashrek and the dodge. And Sumail will actually fall for his blood here. I have no idea what he was doing. Did he not see the Lashrek coming? I thought that war spotted him out, but I guess Sumail had a different idea. And look at that, Sheiky getting right back into the game with a regen rune. Perhaps being a little aggressive. Sumail was there. PPD does have a frostbite, will use it. AUI, what does he have? He has a slow, and that's it. Just harassing him out of the lane. LaSalle popped by the Radiant team, this time on the Spirit Breaker. And aggressive on top of the leaderboard here. 19 and 12. Clockwork is absolutely getting nothing. But he did skill Flare, so he will find a bit of gold that way, just like so. Not too much going on here. Ever since the first blood, anyways. Both teams just trying to outplay each other in the last hit departments. Sheiky just cannot find the touch. Universe. Nope, the doppelganger. Oh, in the charge, Sumail once again falling. And here you see the power of CDEC simply rolling over the Storm Spirit on EG. And way too fast for any rotation. Even if CM or Skywrath were to teleport, it would have been way too late. They would have to anticipate that before they even got to Sumail. But the charge, what a spell. Perhaps the perfect hero here for CDEC with the way they're playing this tournament. And here we go, another charge. Will Sumail see this coming though? Will there be support? There's a number two Shadow Strike and Q slowing him down. Still no TP, and Sumail will fall again. That is three deaths on your Storm Spirit. Oh my, Sheiky. Oh, and Universe from downtown will take out Sheiky. All right, not too bad here. However, you do not want your Storm to be getting delayed on his level 6, let alone his farm. He's still ahead in the last hit here, but what are we looking at here in net worth? The Quap is ahead because of the kills, and Storm a little bit behind, around 600 gold here. But you know what? You gotta believe in EG. They'll make a comeback here. Their Gyro free farming as of now. Spirit Break has left the lane and the comeback jungle. Here we go, and look at this, the smoke gank already. But they might get popped here. SB might be too close, hugging the wall. Oh no, they do not get revealed, so they're actually gonna go for top. But do EG sense anything? No heroes on the map except for PL and Winter Wyvern. That's three heroes missing, and these guys are just roaming the jungle. And let's see, will they find anything? Smoke revealed, and a charge. AUI. Oh, he will live. The sounds on Sheiky. PPD. He does have a frostbite, I believe. He does, and Sheiky will fall, and what a turn by EG! 2-0 in favor. Now, if only I can find that button to show. Oh my goodness, and XZ! And that is making 3-0 In favor of EG, he tried to charge out of the way. But no, the reaction from the supports there. Very well played, EG. And that creating a lot of space for your Sumail. A couple games I've seen Sumail play, he can die countless times on the storm, but he will always find a way to come back for whatever reason. He is an amazing kid, 16 years old of age, showing the old folks what's up. We got an S4 rune here on Storm Spirit, the haste. Let's see if he'll do anything with it. There's a Spirit Breaker at mid lane here. Probably understand that he does have haste on and possibly nothing that they can do to the storm right now. So Sumail will simply go back to the jungle, get that net worth up, and he's already overtaking the Quap after being down 600 gold not too long ago. But, you know, a couple deaths here and there, and next thing you know, EG back on top, 8 minute rune coming up, and Bounty will go to aggressive, bottling up. Is that a drum I'm looking at on that Bracer? We'll see. Not too much happening now. Seems like after falling on that top lane, they've remained a little bit passive. And the regen rune on Sumail. He is level 6, perhaps looking to dance with the zip here. And he's going on mid. Here we go. And the silence. This looks like another Death of Shiki. No, the blink. Very close, but there was no pull on Sumail, and silence does not last long enough. However, they do force a TP. And not much was really wasted. And Universe with the ulti, but Q easily disengages with that Q spell of his. Aggressive. Are they looking to turn the TP on Universe, understanding that there is no way of them canceling his TP, and he does make it out alive. No problem there. Shiki having a very, very hard time here in the mid lane. Not too much to show for Sumail, just piling on that net worth in the jungle. AUI, wow, already in Arcane Boots. Perhaps letting PBD take care of all the awards and sentries. Not too much from CDEC here. They were looking really, really great, but perhaps they're just looking for smart fights now instead of just throwing their bodies around. Haste rune, and he will activate it in Universe. Thought he might save it for Storm, but guess not. Shiki picks up a bounty rune here. Treads completed. A little bit more tanky here. Universe looking to make a play. Does have the haste rune, but it will run out. He will flare down, grab some gold perhaps, push the lane, and Garter also with a mana boot, a TP. These guys are not that poor at all. Perhaps only the Spirit Breaker struggling as a support. Even the CM has more, but that's because PPD is able to farm the jungle with his Frostbite. Easily killing big creeps. Now, Hook is up. AUI is smoked. So is Universe. And, oh no, he missed. Garter misses the stun. XZ with the ulti. And the scream of pain. One down. Clockwork is out. Fear. Call down. Looking to turn. Sumail. And EG turns it around. 2-0. Lashrak PL. Huge win for EG here, perhaps looking to push down mid tower. No, they will fall back, but you can see, oh, gold change, 700 and XP 800 in favor of EG there. You know, very quick to react there. You know, Clockwork Dying for a PL and a Shrek? Well, they'll take that 10 times out of 10. Queen of Pain clearing stacks here. Just finding any way he can catch up. But you can already see the two top net worth going to EG's way if they can maintain this lead and not take bad fights. It should be EG having the dominance here. Aggressive, following up for that bounty rune. Now, from what I've heard, this does not seem to be the playstyle for CDEC, and maybe EG has found a way to nullify their aggressiveness. Storm and CM smoked up. Regen for Sumail. Very fortunate with these runes, and a missed hook here. But Sumail with the regen, the silence, and he just completely blows up. The kill will go to Universe on that snipe of Rocket Flare. Now the mid lane, it'll be glyphed up. Still has the regen on Sumail, but should be running out soon. Will he go on aggressive? He does have two in pull. He's gonna casually hit him, and the pull, the call down, Sumail. Will go in and aggressive. Full fall to Shrek as well. Another pick off from EG. CDEC perhaps feeling the pressure from TI5 Grand Finals. A little jittery here to start off game one, but you can never count out these guys. Plenty of upsets, and we have seen them take out EG as well. But looking a little bit rusty here in game one. We'll see if they can turn this around. I mean, still early. 9-4 in favor of EG, obviously. A TP here from XZen, and PP did not see that. Otherwise, he probably would have canceled it. Spirit Breaker TPing mid, but they're not really doing much at this point. Here comes a charge. Not too much mana on the Storm. Is he gonna keep going? The Quap, will she blink? No. Sumail, sensing a little bit of danger, will zip away. And he'll go all the way back to the fountain. Meanwhile, Fear, the Helm Denominator, is just stacking for himself. And, you know, it's really easy with the flat cannon to clear out these big camps and grabbing himself a humongous load of gold and experience. Once again, smoked up in the jungle, but no one, absolutely no one, in the enemy jungle here. But they will put down a ward. Just trying to find any way to find a pickoff. And the flare will actually spot them out here. No pings coming out, though. All right. Aggressive, taking the top tower. A much needed net worth increase. And actually, that is the first tower that goes down, very surprisingly. Got new flare with the parachute down. Gotta get me one of those. Sheiky not doing too much. Trying to use that Scream of Pain and Sonic Wave combo. Just simply not finding any opening. And look at this, you see this. They are sticking together, understanding that they do not want to be separated with the combo of Spirit Breaker, easily intercepting anyone that is in a bad position. Storm will TP, Sumail up top, already looking to defend. CDC isn't even looking to push. They will see Sumail here. That newly placed ward. Is there any way that they can turn this around? A charge from Spirit Breaker from a very far distance. Sumail, will he react in time? And he will! PPD, there's the frostbite. Will he turn the silence? And there goes XZ. What looked like a gank attempt on the storm turns, and the clockwork hook. He will get Garter. Lashrek will fall here on the call down and are looking for more storm on cue. There he goes. Another 3-0 pickoff. EG looking terrific. And Storm once again with the regen rune. Just how many regen rune does he have? Downtown Zip cannot find Cheeky, but he will find Farm. EG looking extremely great here in this opening match. Perhaps looking to push the top tower here. They got the Skywrath ulti. Always wonder what it was called. Anyways, let's take a look at the graph here. Already in XP difference, almost 8K and difference in team net worth. Nearly 6K. Pulling away EG is. And their late game is scary, mighty scary. You've seen the statistics for Storm as the game goes on. His percentage just simply goes way up. That Zip is no joke. A little deny here from Q. Not allowing the Storm Spirit to pick up the rune. I need some water. Smoke on CM here. Perhaps looking to make a play. They have great vision on the enemy Radiant jungle. They're easily able to simply farm out their jungle and slowly find a pickoff or push. Got the SB on top lane. PL trying to farm. Look at the Gyro just pulling ahead. He is 2700 ahead of the PL. We had the hookup. Every ultimate is up on EG side. And will Sumail be able to? No, he won't. That was strange. Why did he not attack him there? Alright, that was PPD. Was there a gank attempt there on mid? I don't know. Bad camera work here. Aggressive. Oh, and he will fall. The call down last second. The Quap Sonic Wave, but very healthy in terms of HP for EG still. Garter looking to fall here. Another 3-0 pickoff. 15-4. Game 1 looking like a blowout here. This should be an easy tier 1 here. They're not even waiting for the creeps. They're saying, you know what? No backdoor protection on tier 1s. We're just going to go ahead and force this Glyph. And Fear Company rampaging down. Using a few words from TI5 announcers. And perfect time for the rune. 20 minute. EG. Simply starving out their teams, it seems like. Spirit Breaker just TPing out here. Sensing danger, aggressive. Storm with that Orchid. Especially this early in the game. With your opponent's supports just not having anything to deal with it. I mean, the only way of stopping. Oh, and here, look, XZen! And he could not ulti Netherstrike the Storm. And PPD with the ultimate Sheiky. And EG Universe! Where's he going? He's trying to go for the Storm here, but we got CDEC chasing down PPD, and he will fall. Finally, something looking good for you. For the Chinese team here, but it's still only a Crystal Maiden. You know what? I think if Universe turned that around as opposed to running away, they might have been able to turn it around. Garo was on his way, but you know what? They're just gonna play it safe. It is the TI Grand Finals and the support clockwork. The teleport from Clockwork, scaring them off. He has Blade Mail. Sumail running very low on mana here. Are they looking to turn here? PL, Doppelganger, Trying to slow them down any way he can. Sonic Wave is up, but EG still have call down on the Gyro, and oh my goodness, he is farmed. 11K net worth. Looking at net worth, it's just seems to keep increasing. Hook is up. He has blade mail. Great item against Lushtrak for sure. Even the co-op as well. Pure damage. Sonic Wave. And Shiki still does not have any HP. This is time to fight for EG. They should be taking out these tier ones and look, making a play on Garter. But I believe Universal will fall here. But the zip from downtown, Sumail actually turns this around. And aggressive will fall in Spiritbringer as well. Another 3-4-0 exchange. And CDEC getting a taste of their own medicine here. But even still, it's not even EG that are. Oh no, here we have Winter's Curse. Will Sumail fall here? He will! Oh, Radiant Courier has been slain here. And that was huge. That was a huge kill. If they're looking for a comeback, those are the type of plays that they need to make. But you know what? I don't think Sumail needed to be that aggressive, with the way they've been playing safe and sound. You do not want to be playing in CDC's hand. The more you overextend, and here we go, another easy pickoff going away of CDC. But what is this? Fear. Oh, Universe with the cancel on the hook. And Clockwork, level 11 and a 4 staff already. And now looking for the Aghanims. Not too far away now. 10K net worth. About 12K in XP. EG looking really well. I don't know what more you can say about this. EG played great. It was great Dota from you. Your boys in blue. You look at your ward positioning, providing great vision. You can see exactly what CDC is up to. They're just farming the enemy jungle without any worries. And now looking for the Roche at 25 minutes. There's actually no way for them to contest this. Actually, they don't even know. I don't even know if they know that they're doing Roche. Most likely going to Sumail here. And it's going to be the Bloodstone. And just like that, Sumail looking a lot more scary with that Aegis. Spiritbringer did pick up a Midas, but I'm not sure if that is the item here. The game might not last long enough. So what is next for EG? Do they just push down tier 2? In my opinion, that should be the case. They do have Aegis, just gotta push out the top lane here. But the CDC squad hanging and about. Playing slow and steady. Just want to make sure they close out game one properly. Don't give CDEC a chance for a comeback here. We'll start the game out with momentum. Longer this game goes on, the bigger the network increases. And EG are okay with that. It has to be on CDC to make some sort of play here, but it's very hard, especially with the counter initiation from the clockwork, the silence from AEY2K, especially no BKB on the co-op. There's absolutely nothing that they can really do. They jump in, and the turnaround for EG is just simply too strong. Fear is just playing RPG mode here, just knocking down buildings left and right. No contest, they know they can't do much. They gotta use high ground to their advantage. EG don't even need to push here. They should just simply go bottom. Farm out the jungle and go bottom. Rinse and repeat. But perhaps they wanna use that Aegis as it will run out in a couple of minutes. But once again, the experience of fear, making sure that they play this smart. The trade tier 2 for mid tower. But no. They sense the rotation from EG, so they will back off. But the wards just able to locate them anywhere. And then look at that zip, perfectly placed. And goodbye, XZ, goodbye, Garter. And perhaps goodbye, CDEC in game one. Looking very slim here. Already tripling their kill total points. Looking to run down mid with that Aegis still on fear. Quap. Is she gonna TP back? She will. The first high ground defense begins now. The glyph is used. AUI putting that slow on cooldown. Still has the silence and the zip on Sumail. Understanding that he does have the Aegis. Just trying to bait some spells. Zips away. Will they look to re-engage or simply fall back and farm? Oh. Looks like Sumail will opt for farming. Simply slap your opponent with gold now. Next item, the butterfly on Gyro is too much. BKB already completed, and it is 10 second BKB. I don't know if there's a better time to push than now. But it might be too late now. As Sumail's Aegis will run out momentarily. Oh boy. Can you get me some water? Right. Perhaps looking to smoke here. Lanes are fairly pushed out. Maybe not on the bottom lane though. Universe trying to catch XZ here. He will get spotted out. And XZ simply TP out of here. TD on Sumail. He's got 4K gold. What should be the next item? Lingus is not bad here. Winter's Curse, charge. But even still, you kind of welcome the charge as of now. There's absolutely nothing that they can really do as long as EG sticks together. Thank you. Sorry about that, guys. Just taking some medicine. Did they just TP out after? I totally missed that. I think Universe was looking for some players on the Radiant side, but great reaction to escape. Zip will miss. Sheiky will just simply blink out. That was very close. know, that zip and silence, and a split second too late, and it might cost you the racks. Going for tier two here. No contests, obviously. The only thing they can do really do here is play on the high ground and hope for a pickoff. Otherwise, not too much you can do. All right, they got a tier two down, and they said, "You know what? We don't need Aegis. Let's just knock on their door. We have all our items needed: Sumail, Shivas, Clockwork, flying in with the hook. Xed has fallen. Shiki, BKB has fallen there. Oh my goodness, Sumail does way too much damage with that DD rune. Now, simply trying to take the racks. Two have fallen, only three up for CDEC. The first lane of racks will go to EG. Absolutely nothing the Chinese team can do to the North Americans. They're not done. They say, you know what? No buyback, no items. We're just gonna buckle down and knock on your doorsteps. But CEC says, you know what? We're not gonna tap out here. No way. We got a little fight in us. And they're gonna go down in their own terms. But you know what? I actually don't see any way CDEC can come back right now. Man, look at the gyro. He has the net worth of the Quap and PL combined, and Sumail is right up there as well. And behind that, you got your Clockwork. It's just ridiculous. Butterfly completed. Now going for Satag. He will have a whole chunk of HP, and Sonic Wave, even though it has pure damage, might not even do anything. I'm assuming they're just gonna simply wait for the next Rosh, and then they'll just march down middle. But a smoke here. TD rune, is that it? It's kind of hard to. All right, it is. Yes. Now, you know what? Mid is pushing it a little. They might, EG might smell something here. The charge will push down Sumail. The silence on him. The Clockwork Universe, though. BKB being popped. And so. Boy, fear, flat cannon, and just obliterating everybody. 3-0 in favor of EG, and the buyback on Sumail to clean up the rest of the crew. And GG will be called. Game one goes to EG. Your boys in blue. Show them the world how to beat CDEC here on the greatest stage of Dota 2. It's simply great. Simply outplayed CDEC at their own game. They tried to be aggressive, and the counter initiation from EG was simply stunning. Universe played a terrific Clockwork game here. Not much can be said. I mean, everybody played well all around. PPD plays great wards. Sumail died three times in the mid lane, and like I said, he just finds a way to come back and picks up an early orchid and simply started going nuts. You know what, right now? Oh, cool. My compendium got an extra point. I don't know why or how, but okay. Nice. Very good. Now we're just gonna have to wait for game two. So let's take a quick pause here, and I will be back. See you guys in a bit.